Yes! What's up, guys? Welcome back to Cyberbikes channel. Today we're gonna talk about Bafang motors. What breaks down the most in Bafang motors, how to fix that, and how to prevent that from happening again. So today we're gonna spread the parts here on the bench. Problem number one, controller burnout. So the first problem is the motor getting burned because of water damage. And the first way to prevent water damage on a Bafang motor is to add a tape covering the controller gasket and the motor gasket. In this case, it's just the chassis of the motor. We should have the motor core here on the right, you know, and all the gear components here on the right. But this is just to show you exclusively the controller on the Bafang motor. So the controller is on the chain drive side. Okay, and this gasket here is a rubber gasket. When there's too much impurity, dust, contamination, the gasket, the rubber gets dry and loses all its properties. And so water starts to penetrate. So to prevent the water to ingress here, to cause damage on the controller side, I suggest adding a tape at the front of the motor. On its front here. You should never pass the wires too close to the motor like this. Why? Because water will follow the wire direction, and because the angle is so close to the motor that the water will start following the wires, it will come inside of the controller. It will come here inside the controller. So problem number two, excessive torque on the motor shaft. Inside of this shaft here, there is a bearing. So on each side, there are two bearings. There is a roller bearing and there is a ball bearing. When you install your Bafang motor, okay, so you put the mount, the bracket, and you start tightening this nut, you cannot over tighten the nut. Why? We're gonna have the frame here, you know, and as you tighten this bracket, it's gonna compress the frame and will make the motor, like, will start bracing, you know, the bottom bracket of the motor. At the same time that you are torquing, you're adding torque to this nut and screwing it in, you are extending, you know, millimetrically, you know, maybe micrometrically, you know, like in small fractions, but you are deforming this shaft. So what happens? If you over tighten this nut, you're gonna deform the housing of the bearings that are on the inside, and those bearings are gonna break. So how you prevent that from happening? You have to use a torque wrench. However, there's an issue in all this, which is we are trying to improve Bafang engineering, which is hard as well, you know. We are not cooperating. It's not like a two-way talk, you know. They manufacture and we improve whatever we can here at the shop. So if you have a look here at the nut, you're gonna see 50 to 60 Newton meters. 50 to 60 Newton meters are not enough to hold the motor, you know, using this bracket here, to the bottom bracket. So if you use the recommended torque Bafang gives you, you cannot tighten the motor. So you have to exceed the torque of the nut. However, if you over exceed, you damage the housing of the bearings. And that's something we know here at the shop. So we suggest the maximum torque to set the wrench to 80 Newton meters. 80 Newton meters is more than enough to tighten the motor to the bottom bracket and prevent any damage to the housing of the bearings. Okay, so this is problem number two that you're gonna face after installing the Bafang motor if you exceeded in torque when tightening this bracket here, this nut here. Okay, so 50 to 60 Newton meters, it's not enough to hold the motor. Maximum 80 80 Newton meters will hold the motor and won't cause damage to the housing of the bearings. Problem number three. I forgot. Problem number three, communication error, usually error 30. In the Bafang system, error 30 means communication error. Maybe the TX or RX, which are one of the five wires on the inside, they are not communicating properly with the controller. So the communication has to happen between display and controller. If the pins inside are damaged or the cable torn on the inside, you won't have that communication and the error 30 will show up on the display. Sometimes people let those little wires on the way of the headset. So these little wires are flexing left and right, and so they tear on the inside and eventually you're gonna have an error 30, you know, which is communication error. Sometimes water can get in this connector. It's not properly attached to the other side, and it can also cause error 30. If you are having error 30 frequently, I suggest replacing the 1-2-4 cable, the split cable, and probably replacing the display and going for a test ride to see if error 30 is going to come up. Other channels have suggested to flash the controller with a new firmware. However, I have never recovered an error 30 controller, BBS HD controller, with a new firmware. So I cannot say 100% it's gonna work. Other channels said that it works. I can't say. What I suggest is replacing the 1-2-4 cable and the display cable. Problem number four, controller burnout due to bad usage. The phase wires, these are, let's say, the cylinders of an internal combustion engine. So the phase wires, they are pumping energy to the motor. You might cause an over temperature in the controller and it stopped working, or you could have blown the capacitor. If the capacitor has blown up, you won't be able to read the voltage on the display of the Bafang motor. So ride always at the right gear. If your legs are too light, floating in the air, it's wrong. If your legs are too heavy with a low cadence, it's wrong as well. Find the perfect cadence so you don't overheat the controller motor, like this one, burnt. And you're gonna be successful with your Bafang conversion. Problem number five, nylon gear getting wrecked inside of the motor. If you are not using the gears of the bike accordingly, or the chain ring is too big, or, you know, it's always in relation to how you ride the bike, you can have a problem with the nylon gear inside the motor. So the nylon gear is inside of this cover here. Have to undo the stray bolts, you can pop up the nylon gear. The nylon gear is made out of nylon because it requires less lubrication. In comparison to having a metal gear here, you would require constant lubrication and maybe greasing the motor more often, and would be noisier to ride this motor in comparison to a nylon gear. The fact is, nylon is not as strong as metal. And eventually, even though it's an helical gear, you know, so there's more contact area, if you are riding on the wrong gear or too much effort in your riding, you're gonna have the motor rotor, which is this part here, the center part, stripping, damaging, wrecking the nylon gears. So you're gonna be opening the motor to replace the nylon gear. In this case, the nylon gear will work as a fuse. So if you want to prevent the nylon gear from getting damaged, use the gears of your bike. Don't save gears, shift gears, and you prevent opening the motor to replace the nylon gear. Usually, normally, you have to replace the nylon gear of a BBS HD. The BBS HD is the Bafang 1000 watts motor. So this helical gear strips, breaks the nylon gear of the BBS HD. Wanna prevent this problem from happening? Shift gears on your bike, ta 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 ta, and be happy. Problem number six, damaged pinion bearing. The problem with the pinion gear is that the Bafang gears, they are not straight gears. They have an angle. And the chain ring comes in here. If you are riding on a wrong gear, it makes very difficult for this granny gear to rotate. And because it's difficult for the gear to rotate, and this gear is in angle, it's not a straight teeth gear, it's an angle gear, it creates two forces. One, a tangential force, and another one, an axial force. And because of that, the pinion starts to stick out, tries to pop out of the motor in this direction here, up. It will groove the cover. This cover is not that grooved. You can see just a small groove here. However, in motors that have been extremely damaged, you're gonna have kind of a bowl here. You know, you're gonna clearly see that the pinion has been forced against the plastic cover that sits in here, right? And another issue you're gonna have with the pinion, for example, we have the nylon gear in here, we have some elastic rings holding the gear and the pinion in their place, and there is a bearing, you know, you can see the circular shape here. This is the bearing housing. If you look from the inside, you're gonna find a bearing pretty much like this. Actually, this bearing here is the bearing that we upgrade at Cyberbikes. When we find a motor that has a bearing problem like this, we install a steel caged bearing. And the bearings we install here, they are 2 millimeters wider than the original bearing. So it's a stronger bearing. But the fact is, the pinion is inside of this bearing here. Okay? And if we have this gear here making the life of the pinion pretty hard, means forcing the pinion against this direction and producing too much stress on the pinion, the bearing will have a side movement and eventually the bearing breaks and the motor collapses. In that case, you not only have to replace the bearing, but you also replacing the pinion and the granny gear. So basically, sometimes you need a new motor. And how to avoid all that? Changing gears. Back to changing gears, shifting gears. So the chain is passing around here. If you have engaged a very heavy gear, usually the small sprocket on the back wheel, and if you have a big chain ring, the motor will struggle to rotate, okay? Will create too much friction in this engagement here, and eventually will cause the bearing to break. So wanna prevent this problem, wanna prevent replacing the internal bearing of your pinion gear, shift gears, okay? Always make the chain ring very light to rotate and you won't have any mechanical problems with your Bafang motor. Problem number 7, damaged granny gear. What happens? If there's an excessive force between the pinion and the granny gear, look what happened to the granny gear. It lost a tooth. So to prevent that from happening, shift gears, okay? Prevent excessive force on this coupling between granny gear and the pinion gear. And the final problem, number 8, the granny gear is splitting away from the shaft. In this case, we have the BBS 01 and 02 crankshaft and the granny gear. Okay, so this is the outside. Okay, the 5 holes here is where the chain ring goes, and this is on the inside. Can you see that we have a broken part here? This is the broken magnet of the pedal assist sensor. So we should have an entire circle, like rounded magnet here. And what happens? Because the customer wasn't shifting gears, the bolts, the internal bolts here, one, two, three, there's nothing to do with the bolts on the other side, okay? These are the bolts that hold this axle to the granny gear, okay? The customer wasn't shifting gears. The gears are made in an angle. They are not straight gears. So it causes the granny gear to detach from the axle. That detachment not only interferes with the coupling of the granny gear and the pinion gear, but also the bolts start to stick out and start to bend like this, you know, bend the pedal assist magnetic wheel, and then your bike suddenly loses all the pedal assist. So if you want to prevent breaking the magnetic disc and causing problems on the coupling between the gear, the granny gear and the pinion, what you have to do, shift gears, be always on a light gear to allow your chain ring to spin freely. For today's video, that's all. I hope you enjoyed it, you learned something new. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, please write in the comments. If you also have any questions, write down in the comments. I will personally reply all them. And see you next time.